the Xtra Factor Live with Matt Edmondson and Rylan Clark-Neal.
It looks just like this one. Yeah. I've not slept for 36 hours, so this could be an interesting Sunday night on the Xtra Factor Live!
This is my new little catchphrase, your weekend ends right here!
Okay, thank you. All right, two things. They will take it away if you do that.
Sorry,
and also, I explained this last week, it doesn't end right now, does it? Because we've got a whole hour of stuff. We've got exclusive auditions, Roman Kemp, Martin Kemp's son, you know. You heard that?
George Michael's his godfather.
I heard that today.
Learned that today.
He's going to be back with the only stuff on the internet that we're legally allowed to show. And we've got a performance from Aston Merigold at the end of the show. Second appearance on this show.
He's here more than you are,
if
I'm not going to lie. Plus, we're going to be chatting to X Factor's naughtiest judge, Louis Walsh, is right in the getting all emotional here. But for all of that, let's meet tonight's gorgeous celebrity panel. He's just won an Olympic medal and he looks really lovely in a pair of teeny tiny Speedos. It's Tom Daley, everyone! She's a Cowie babe and one-time pop star. It's the one and only Jess Wright! And he is a very, very, very funny man. It's Joel Dommett! But before we join them to chat about all of the auditions we've just seen over on ITV, it is time for a roundup of tonight's show with the Richard to my Judy. Ladies and gentlemen, bring on that chair!
Yes!
OK. Right. You ready?
Capping for two now. Yes, it was another cracking episode of The X Factor. Nicole was delighted when I finally revealed the way I like to eat the contents of a cream egg.
Matt, I'm so happy you don't suck.
Oi!
What a monster. The show kicked off in Manchester tonight, and we all know that the Mancunian accent is unique, but I had no idea that the word place had five L's in it. Place was the Arndale Centre on a Saturday afternoon. I've been there. I don't want to talk about it. Now, one of the first acts to audition were real-life couple Tom and Laura, and they had some big ambitions.
And what's the big dream, guys?
What are we saying? Global stardom, a sell-out stadium tour, maybe a house made of platinum discs?
I think I want four yeses, and then probably a Nando's.
Each of the stars. Next up was Freddie Parker, and during his audition, Dermot revealed that mentioning dogs in front of the judges gives you an advantage.
Should have brought some dogs in.
Yeah. We could bring two.
That's a guaranteed three yeses.
Hang on a minute. Did Dermot say a guaranteed three yeses?
Oh.
But there are four judges. Which one is a cat person? What do you reckon? My bet is probably on Louis because he loves. We then had an incredible performance from Chanel, who brought out Simon's inner respect for Wandsworth.
I'm from Wandsworth, Southwest London.
Big up!
Yes! I like that move. In fact, I think it might actually be catching.
Thank you. Whoopee!
Yes, big up Wandsworth. We also met auditionee Irina, and while she seemed to tickle Simon's fancy, Sharon didn't seem so keen.
You remind me of a baddie from a James Bond movie.
Oh. All right, steady on, Sharon. Sure, she's not that bad. She probably hasn't even given a second thought as to how she would attempt to destroy the world.
I'm gonna make it like great explosion, like a bomb.
Okay, she has. We're all doomed. We're all doomed. And finally, one of the most memorable auditions of the night came from Sada Vido. And do you know what? I knew this would happen. It's the sleep thing. I'm struggling to remember exactly how she described herself.
I'm a doll.
Well, I'm a doll.
I'm a doll. And I'm a living doll.
You're a living doll.
Just a living doll.
Sada, you're not a doll.
I'm a doll.
You're not a doll.
I am a living doll.
She's not a doll.
She's a doll.
Very happy doll.
What was it? I still have no idea. It's escaped me. And that was Series 13, Episode 4 of The X Factor.
Get over it! Come on, give him a round of applause.